guys? It's Lindsay, and I'm back for another video. Okay, so today we are doing another Goodwill bins thrift haul. This trip, I will say, was definitely a lot better than the last couple trips that I have gone and done in terms of quantity, because the quantity has not been that great the last couple times that I've gone. This finally felt like a trip where it was like, oh my god, I'm finally getting stuff. It was probably like, I think they were rotating like every 20 minutes or something. Like, it was crazy. And I had gone on a Sunday, and normally when I go on Sundays, they do not rotate that fast, so that was great also. So let's go ahead and get into it. I think there's about 25 items here, so I will try to get through this as fast as I can. Let's go ahead and get into the haul. Okay, so the first thing is this vintage Jones New York suit, size 14. This is just like a business casual. I think this is like a tunic mini dress type thing. I'm not really sure, but as everyone knows, like the girl boss, you know, trend is very popular right now. And so this is very like business office corporate type vibes. Okay, this is a Zara size small, and this is a linen blend dress, and it's just got a little belt. Now, I will say this is like really, 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 really short, so I can't imagine this being a mini dress, but hey, to each their own. Okay, I had said somewhere that I really wanted to try to find Aritzia this year, and look, I found some Aritzia. Found this Wilfred size extra small, but this is, I'm not really sure, it's like a swing dress, I think, kind of like a high-low swing dress. I don't know style-wise what this is, but it does have two holes right here on the front, if you can see them. Nothing too big though. Next is this Carhartt full zip jacket. It's a J149 style. It's a large tall, but it does just seem older based on how this tag looks and how this tag looks. So I don't know if it's actually vintage. Maybe it's like mid-2000s, or maybe it's 2012 or something. I don't know. This is just like a faded full zip. These are a size large. They're vintage Looney Tunes 2004, but they just say blah, 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 and it's got Tweety, and they're just like a sleep lounge pant. Here is the tag on that. And then it says 2004 on the back there. Another Patagonia vest. This is a size large. And this is just like that really soft fleece. This obviously has been worn just because it does have like kind of like a wash wear flattened, you know, ness to the fleece. This is a vintage Gap long sleeve shirt in a size large. Just a plain little striped long sleeve. This was fun. I have never found this brand before. So this is Prairie Underground in a size large. Conveniently enough, it's made in Seattle. And this is just like a little like plaid checkered top. No idea how much this will sell for, but it seemed like most everything in this brand was selling for $50 or more at least. So I think it should be a pretty decent sale. Next, getting into a couple shirts. So this I had contemplated throwing back just because I didn't think this was worth anything really. But I know in the past Disney Couture on like purses, I think, has done okay. But it's Alice in Wonderland. So it's Alice in Wonderland print. There's nothing on the back. Size extra large, but it's a 2006 Mighty Fine. And then this was in the corner of a bedding bin. So like I've said, check your bedding because there's stuff in there. This is a vintage Freeze size youth large, dated down on the bottom, 1995 Warner Brothers. And this is just a vintage Tasmanian Devil, like, baseball style shirt, and it just says, look out for my attitude. Okay, next. So this is a very big shirt, but it is vintage. My guess is that this is probably like a 4X. I could be wrong. It is an Auburn, Alabama 2000 shirt. And even though we just got out of college football season, Alabama is obviously a very popular school. And it does have like a big hole down here in the corner. This is what I think is also vintage, just based off how it looks. But this is Team Arctic Cat Racing. And I just saw this in the bin and I thought this looked so cool. It's so like streetwear, sportswear. And this is a size extra large. So there's the tag on that. This is just a University of Washington Center Swoosh Nike, Nike team shirt. Nothing on the back. Also found this on my way out. This is a Juicy Couture little velour track jacket. And I think this is a size medium, but to me, it kind of seems like it might be like a kid's medium. It's in this like seafoam green color. Here's another t-shirt. This is the Nike tee, size extra, extra large. And this is based off of the 2020 Summer Olympics. So it says just do it, and then it says 2020 in gold, which is kind of hard to see. And then it's got all the flags of all the countries all around it. This has this stain down here at the bottom that I did not stain treat, but it didn't come out with a normal wash. Obviously the Olympics are happening this summer, and so anything Olympics is probably gonna be more like searchable right at the moment. Okay, this also in trend with what is going on right now. Tomorrow, Sunday, so I'm filming this on Saturday. Tomorrow, though, on Sunday, is the Super Bowl, and Usher is performing at the halftime show. I don't know what year this tour was, but great timing for finding an Usher shirt right as he's about to perform in the Super Bowl. And this is a size small. Okay, another vintage bedding that you know that I love to find. This is just the fitted sheet. So just a vintage Winnie the Pooh fitted sheet. So that will be great. This is a vintage Reebok 2XL. And this is from 2002 maybe? 100% nylon. And this is a Seahawks football jersey, and it's Strong, which I think his name was Mac Strong, M-A-C-K, I'm pretty sure. So I know we're getting out of football season, but I feel like these, you know, Reebok jerseys normally do okay. Plus it's a bigger size. For some reason, I found a lot of I found a lot of good kids stuff this time around. So this is a Nike Dry Fit size medium. So there's the tag on that. And this is just a little soccer jersey. I believe this is FC Barcelona, maybe? Yeah, FC Barcelona. And the little Nike logo, like this is embroidered and this is like a patch type thing. This is in great shape. And the next kid item, this is a vintage Harley Davidson, size 2-4, 100% cotton. This does not have a date or anything on it, but it is single stitch and it is made in the USA. But it's just this little, here's the front and here's the tag on that, and then made in the USA on the back there. And this is Los Angeles Harley Davidson. I just think this is like the most adorable little shirt. This is so cute. And then next is this. So I found this in a bin and I was like, I'm not really sure what this is, but it looks like very well made because it's so intricate with all these little like designs and everything on it. And it's the same way on the back, and it's in really, really, really good shape. The only thing is that the zipper on this is broken. So you can still wear it as a jacket, but there's no zipper at all. One of the last kid items is this Harley Davidson size 5-year size 5 year little full zip hoodie. So it's got this on the front, and then it's got this on the back. And then we also got two pairs of shoes. So these are the Nike, I think they're like Nike Burrows or something. I'm not really sure. The only thing I will say is that someone replaced the laces in them. So these are like adult shoelaces. So they're like way too long for these shoes. And the like Velcro strap part that should go around the top of the shoe was removed for some reason on both of them. But other than that, I mean, they're in pretty good like play shape. And these are a size US 2 years. Okay, and then last but not least, I found these Uggs as I was leaving. So these are the, they're like the Ugg Numeral boot or Numeral boot or something like that. I don't remember what the name is. The only thing is that they do have like paint on the front of them. Obviously someone painted or something, and they do have like some scuffs here and there, but otherwise like in the, well, I guess the bottoms do have a little bit of wear, but for the most part, like even the insides look pretty good. Like they're not as balled up as they could be. Okay, so that is everything. That is the whole haul. So all of that together was 17 pounds. And it was $33.83 total. So it was, like I said, 20, I think about 25 things for that amount. So I think it averaged out to be like $1.30 or something an item, which I am never that low on my cost of goods at the bins, or I haven't been for the last couple months. So that was that was pretty great that I was able to get so low on my cost of goods. But let me know what you thought of the haul down below. Obviously, give this video a like if you made it all the way through. Obviously, subscribe as well to see more bins thrifting content, because like you know, I go to the bins almost every weekend. So there is always some kind of bins content to be had. But other than that, thank you for watching, and I hope to see you guys in the next one. Bye!